Hey everybody, I'm super excited to announce a new contest starting today. We're doing a back to school contest, a really fun activity and project with isopods. So get ready to learn. We're gonna start out by meeting these fun little creatures that live everywhere. They really are found all over the place. So in my tank here, we have some awesome little creatures. These are isopods. And what we have today are a zebra variety. They've got these really pretty black and white stripes. They're not bugs, they're actually crustaceans. So they're more related to lobsters and shrimp. They breathe with gill-like organs. Okay, so there's none left on here. There is his little dude. Can you see him?
Yeah.
Yay! And they're found all over the world. They're mostly detritivores, which means that they eat decomposing matter, often decomposing leaves and wood and things like that. They're really important for our environment, and they're found everywhere. They're all around us. They're really like in your backyard. They're not dangerous to handle. They're very easy to find. And so what we want to do today is show you how you can set up your very own isopod habitat with things that you have at home. You don't have to go out and buy anything. You're just gonna put together these materials, go out, find some isopods, and learn from them. And then if you fill out our super fun activity sheet here and upload it to the webpage, we will enter you to win a prize. Now, everybody who sends something in is going to win something, but one lucky entrant from each age category is gonna win 10,000 pennies. $100! That you can buy so many isopods with that. Or, I don't know, a lizard or something. All kinds of things. So, please, enjoy as we show you how to build your isopod habitat in your home and go out and find some isopods. Keep learning, keep exploring, keep being curious, and have fun. All right, so we are going to show you how to make at home an isopod habitat. And here is one example of a finished product. We've got the jar with the substrate in here, some food for them, and some isopods. So this jar is one that was probably purchased for the purpose, who knows, but you don't have to use a fancy jar like this. You can use something like spaghetti sauce jar. This is a box that came with Christmas lights in it. This is perfect. You could use a box that had, can't even open it. There we go, deli meat, or some kind of container that you can recycle from home. And first you're gonna wanna wash it out to make sure there's no spaghetti sauce left over in your jar, things like that. So you're gonna find a container. You do wanna make sure that your container can have some circulation in it, some kind of ventilation. So if you have a jar like this, you could very carefully use a drill to drill some holes in your jar. You could drill some holes in your lid of your plastic container, or this one has some mesh netting. You do want to have some kind of a cover on there to keep your little fellas from climbing out of the jar. So you could do something like this. If you have a more solid top, that's going to help retain a little bit more humidity, so you'll have to add less water later, but this is definitely an option. And another option is, let's do it in here. You have a jar like this, you can use some plastic saran wrap. And all you're gonna do is, cut a piece that's big enough. You can even double over if you want to. Prepare it on the top of your jar and then hold it in place with a rubber band. Then you can use a pen or a little knife and just poke a few holes right in there to allow some circulation, but also keep your habitat secure. So that's all you need for a container, something really simple. You already have this at home, I'm sure of it. So get your containers. Next, we're going to get some dirt, some rotting wood or bark, maybe some moss, some dried leaves. But the good news is you don't have to go out and purchase any of this either. You can pick it up even while you're picking up your isopods. So it's a good idea even to collect materials from around the area where you collect your isopods to make sure that it's the substrate that they're used to, the bark and the leaves that they like to eat, things like that. So we've got all of our materials together, and I'm going to show you how to build your isopod habitat. The jar is a really great one. This way you can kind of see right through. In your box, you could take off the sticker so that you have a better view looking in at your creatures. I'm gonna go ahead and use the box this time just because I think it's gonna show up a little better on the camera. So first I'm gonna remove the lid. It's already been rinsed out. I'm gonna add in a layer of dirt. If you do a nice deep layer in there, it's gonna help retain moisture. Now remember, isopods are crustaceans. So they're breathing through gill-like structures, and those need to remain moist. We don't want them to dry out. So if you want to retain some humidity and have some moisture in there, a nice deep layer of a soil that is going to absorb water is really helpful. Next, I'm gonna put in my bark. I'm gonna pick this piece. Nope, I'm gonna pick the other piece. You can be really selective. No, you can do it however you want. Put in a little bit of moss. And I am ready for isopods. While I'm out there collecting, I'm gonna also pick up some of the leaves and other rotten material that's in the habitat that they're already living in, so I make sure that they have what they really like. Now remember, isopods are decomposers. They eat rotting wood, leaves, moss, bark, stuff like that, so they're pretty easy to feed. One note is you do wanna collect these materials from an area where it's not really heavy traffic, where there's not a lot of people walking around or driving and things like that. First of all, be safe. Don't go out and collect. You won't find them in the middle of the road anyways, but be safe. Second of all, if there's a lot of traffic, you might find more contaminants around. And so you wanna try to find like some relatively clean leaves and clean soil and things like that so that you're not introducing dirt and or yucky contamination chemicals or things like that from outside. So find a park, woods, backyard, something like that where you know you have some clean materials to choose from. All right, let's go get some isopods. So when you're out searching for isopods, there's a couple of good places to look. And where I always like to look is find a lawn, go to a park or something like that. And if there's a sidewalk walking through the lawn, look right between the sidewalk and the grass. And that's a really good spot. Isopods usually love to be there. We don't actually happen to have a sidewalk here, but what I do have is this big stone. And so where the grass meets up with the stone, I'm just gonna gently kind of pull that back, push that aside, and see if there's some isopods in here. Sometimes if you move some of this debris, see these grass clippings and leaves and stuff, that's what they love to eat. I saw a couple over here. Oh, there's one. He's walking up the rock. There he is. There we go. So there's our little isopod. Also called roly-polies because he'll roll up into a little ball. I can add him into my container. And make sure that I'm going to take, I see a couple more down there too. I'm going to take some of this, the grass clippings and some leaves that I find in this area. because I know that that's what he's gonna wanna eat. So on one of the questionnaires, you might be asked, were there any other creatures where you found your isopods? So make sure that when you're picking up your isopods, maybe take a look at the questions before you go out hunting, and so you can be able to answer those questions. I want to know what the habitat here is like. It's a little bit moist, not too dry. There's lots of this vegetation around. It's protected by this nice big rock. Look, there's another one. This is a great spot for isopods. Well, thanks for joining us on our adventure today. I hope that you guys can go out and find some isopods, get your habitat together, and look for the description, the video description. The details are gonna be in there for how to enter our contest. Remember, you could win $100 just for filling out the form that goes along with this contest. Have fun, keep learning, stay safe. Bye-bye.